What is the role of the RMT General Secretary? The General Secretary is in overall charge of the administration of the union and is also considered to be the main spokesperson for the union. The General Secretary's role is set out in the union's rulebook and includes conducting the union's correspondence, preparing reports and documents, keeping membership records, providing services, convening and keeping records of the annual general meeting and other meetings, and attending these meetings with the right to speak but not vote. What is the relationship between the General Secretary and the National Executive Committee? The General Secretary is a non-voting member of the National Executive and a member of all its subcommittees. The General Secretary convenes and keeps records of National Executive meetings. The General Secretary obeys the instructions of the National Executive Committee. How long is the General Secretary's term of office? The General Secretary is elected for a 5-year term and may stand for re-election at the end of their term. They have to retire at the age of 65. How is the General Secretary elected? First, branches nominate candidates. Every member may attend their branch and vote for their preferred candidate. Some branches invite the candidates to speak to the branch and answer questions. Others may circulate material from the candidates. A candidate must receive at least 10 branch nominations to be included in the election. Candidates and their supporters will campaign, asking for members' support. Then, every member of the union is sent a ballot form for the election with a 300-word election address from each candidate. The law states that the election vote has to be conducted by post only. What voting system is used? The union uses the single transferable vote system. Members indicate their preferred candidates in order. When the ballot papers are counted, if one candidate receives more than half of the first preference votes, they are elected. If not, then the lowest scoring candidate is eliminated and their votes are transferred to the voters' second choice candidates. This process continues until one candidate has more than half the votes and is elected, and becomes the RMT General Secretary.